we are here in the home of our doula.
Hello. Hi.
Do you want to say hi? Want to say hi to the camera? This is Delphina.
Hi.
And you guys might be wondering what a doula is. What does that have to do with your birth? Kasi diba, we're talking about everything that you might wanna research or know already while you're
pregnant.
Expecting. Mm-hmm. So we both had Irina as our doula. And ano ba yun? Okay. Kasi hindi yan masyadong common na term here in the Philippines.
Yes.
So Irina, can you tell us what is a doula?
A doula is a professional birth companion.
Professional birth companion.
Yeah, so it's somebody who is knowledgeable about birth.
Okay.
About the entire physiology, about the whole process of giving birth.
Yes.
But it's not a doctor, and it's not a midwife.
So doulas don't have the same license as midwives or
exactly. Not the same license, not the same training. Doula is there really for the mother to provide the one-on-one support through the entire process.
From pregnancy till the delivery.
From pregnancy, particularly through birth. Yeah.
Through birth,
usually
yes.
The work starts with pregnancy or in pregnancy.
But
that's the youngest doula.
Yes, doula in the house. She assisted her mom's birth. Oh, diba?
Right, Delphina? Yeah, doula is from a Greek term of a woman who serves.
Woman who serves.
Because traditionally, women have always been giving birth
by
in
other
the company
women
of other women.
Yes,
and there is always somebody in the community who is knowledgeable about birth and who has a set of skills. And usually those are the midwives, right? So midwife plus women of the house.
Right.
Sisters, titas, aunties, moms, right?
Friends. Yeah.
So this is what women need. The company of compassionate women
who understand what you're going through.
Physically
and emotionally.
Physically and emotionally.
Yes.
And you know, I've heard of so many birth stories wherein they have their husbands in the room. And this is not to vilify the husbands, because my own husband was really great support during Manu's birth.
My husband
also
took the best photo.
So, diba? But for some births at least, I would hear that their husbands made it worse. Because they're very alienated from the process.
Yes.
And nobody walked them through like what a woman really needs during the time of the baby's birth and all that. But I mean, it's a case-to-case basis. Not every, say hi. Okay. So, I also have a dulo.
A dulo?
A dulo. Assisted me for
a male dulo.
The Manu's
that's true.
Birth.
Yeah.
So, that's what a dulo is. Somebody who, a birth companion. Is that the...
A professional birth companion.
I wanna talk more about the professional. Because I'm pretty sure that you had to take classes and you are certified.
Of course.
So, having a dulo with you is not like just having a friend who did not get certified or did not learn anything about
okay guys,
real life interviews.
we are here.
Okay.
So I want to talk about the professional
process.
What did you do to be a doula?
Okay, well, first of all, I gave birth myself
to
understand what it's all about, right? Of course, but it's just the first step, and it was not yet to be certified.
Right.
You know, it's to become a mother and give birth to a child, right? But that whole experience was so powerful and so transformational, and I had amazing women around me. I had 3 midwives with me in my first home birth.
What?
And, yes,
3 midwives.
Like right here where we're sitting. And I realized what it means to have women around, another birthing woman. Yes.
How empowering it was.
How can I pay
serve
forward?
As well?
Like, how can I serve other women? And this is when I heard about the profession of doula that apparently has been already well established in the United States, but quite new in the Philippines.
Okay.
Yeah. So I certified with Childbirth International. It's an online training program, very vigorous. Where you learn everything about the physiology of birth, also the current medical system, and then you're required to assist at least 3-4 births and reflect on them in detail, and then like receive a feedback
mentors.
From the mentors of the certifying. Yeah, so I think I packed about 50 births just for my certification.
Wow.
Yeah, that, yeah, observed, assisted. And it was a great immersion in the world of birth, like to really see mostly very straightforward scenarios of how women give birth.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I also want them to understand why it's very important, especially for first-timers, because that's my own experience. I already heard about the doula, but because back then, 6 years ago, it wasn't a thing.
There was
I was like, why would I even pay extra for this? What? How is that different from the support of, let's say, my OB, or if others are getting a midwife? How is it different to have a doula?
Exactly.
Yeah, so like when they get you, when they first meet with you, like
what are the things?
Yeah, what do you provide, or what do you look for in your possible client?
Okay. Well, first of all, it is important to understand if a mother plans to give birth in the hospital, what is expecting her there, right?
Okay.
I think originally, more than 100 of years ago, when the birth slowly moved from the home premises
to the hospital.
It was originally planned that every birthing woman would receive a one-on-one support from a nurse.
Okay.
And I think for some time it was the case until the hospital became
very busy. Right.
And there was no longer space for one-on-one.
Which is the state of our maternal health in the Philippines here.
Oh, well,
yeah. Right?
But even in private hospitals, you will no longer get
one-on-one support.
Like the nurses will come, they will check on you, they will be an assigned nurse, but it doesn't equal a continuous one-on-one support. So somebody who will be clued into you, into your needs, into everything. If she wants to be massaged, if she wants to be offered water, if she wants to change position, and their focus is the progress of labor,
And just checking the vital signs,
And the vital signs. Mm-hmm. And this is what their scope of responsibility is. It doesn't expand to a continuous one-on-one personal support through the entire process of labor.
Because your needs go beyond just the vital signs, right?
Well, that massage thing that she's talking about, like personally, from our own experience,
was so helpful. So
from my personal experience too,
So many births end up in being heavily medicated, or they would have to open you up just because you were not able to manage the pain. Because pain, we're not gonna lie to you, can it's be there. Present. Mm. I mean, some will have painless births. I don't know how they go through that.
I want to have one.
there are, right?
Because births are so different. Yes. Some are short, quick, easy, smooth.
Right.
Barely noticed, really. Right. Like, there are accounts of that. And some are somewhere in the middle. And some are long,
really long,
and complicated, right?
Long. Okay. If you're like me, you get really long kinds of labor, and you could encounter not really problems or complications, but little challenges along the way that might make you give up right away.
Yeah.
It is very important that someone can massage you, and even pep talk.
Pep talk,
And pep talk, exactly.
My goodness.
Somebody who is attuned to your personality and to your present needs.
Right.
Right.
As they change during the process.
Yes.
All this as a science also. Mm-hmm. Like, you know exactly how to, because a massage from like the spa is different from
it's on particular points where I know it's relieving for a woman in labor. Exactly.
I think it's helpful that your doula has given birth herself, so you know.
In my last birth, I had a four hands massage on my lower back. Four hands from my doulas, from my midwife. I had to have it because it was intense.
Right.
And I wouldn't miss a second of it. To emphasize, birth is not just physiological process. It's a deep psychological process.
Yes.
It's a deep spiritual process. Mm. And all in all, it's a very transformative process in every woman's life.
I mean, it really is a transition,
A transition.
A human being is going to pass.
It's a
that in itself should tell you this is no small thing.
Yes.
So you need as much support as you can.
Exactly.
And that's really what I feel like a doula can give
So aside of the physiological aspect that is mostly looked at and assessed, in the hospital setting, if you choose to give birth in the hospital, right? What doula can bring in is really yeah, take care or watch or tune in your psychological and your spiritual and
so
your
good.
Physical, also physiological journey through this process.
And if they get you as doula, the other thing is you get to meet with them one-on-one.
Absolutely,
before,
right? Absolutely.
So how many
it's
times
not a new face that shows up over there and like, hey, I'm your doula, okay, so we're gonna do that and that. No, we meet during pregnancy.
I think we met twice or thrice before, right?
I mean, we met three times.
Three times before the actual labor.
Birth, right.
Yes. And then she made me do some exercises.
Right.
I remember that, like she would teach some exercises to help me put my baby in the most optimal position.
I'm actually very excited because later on we're gonna stand up.
Yeah.
We're gonna let Irina show us some of the, because I would have to vouch for that. I mean, like during my birth, she had made me stand up and do all of these different positions and
whole
exercises.
The whole repertoire. I had to take the whole bag of tricks. Everything I knew, I had
to
apply for that birth.
In position for him to come down. And it worked. I mean, it worked because we kept moving. And later on, she's going to show us a version of the spinning babies, right? So if you guys are very new to that concept of spinning babies, maybe you want to search it up. But she was perfect. Because, I mean, like, honestly, I can study that by myself. That's my thinking. But when you're in labor, you actually forget everything.
Yes. It's important.
It's not where your priorities are. Your priority is to be with each and every contraction.
Right,
and rest in between.
Yes.
There is no more space to think about
true.
Anything.
And that also segues to the other thing that I wanted to ask you. Because having you there made me feel like there's less work on from my end. It's like, I'm not gonna think about what position to get into.
Right.
She's gonna tell me because she's looking at me 24/7.
If you need to.
That's the idea. That if ever you need her, she will be there.
Because
I remember, like, sometimes people would say that having your husband in the room is enough. And I agree that it's a big help. But the thing is, especially for first-time parents, it's also your husband's first time to actually see, you know, labor, birth. So, obviously, even if he studies everything, parang... It's still hard to remember,
I've heard stories where the husbands are asking for epidural for themselves. They're like, epidural for me!
Hindi kasi totoo, di ba? Even if, or even not just husbands, just partners or like feeling mo people who are great support for your birth. But if they've never seen a birth or they've only seen very few,
I agree.
It's different with the expertise
it's
of someone like a doula.
Different with
diba?
A trained eye. Like how many births have you witnessed already and assisted?
Going to 200.
Wow.
Yeah. I mean, like that in itself for me counts for something. If you've seen at least 200 births, then most probably you've seen one or two like me.
Plus,
and you kind of know what
kasi
to do.
Because every birth nga is different, like Irina said.
Yeah.
So it's good because the more experience she gets, the next time she does it, she'll also have more knowledge. Oh, I've seen this before.
Right.
Like this is what worked. Yes. And then next time, okay, I'll try another style because this one is not working. So the training, I think what you're paying for really, like in my case, what you're really paying for is the trained eye. Like, okay, at least I don't have to worry about that.
Right.
I can just be concentrate on the birthing part and my husband can concentrate on
sleeping. Because I think it's a big
sleeping. Just kidding.
It's a big block in your way when you're being fearful. Like, is my baby still okay? Am I still doing it correctly? And you're, because you don't know and no one's affirming you, you're just being in fear the whole time, and sooner or later that's just gonna tense up your body and you can't give birth anymore. But here's another question that I wanted to ask you. So you've witnessed a lot of births, you've assisted them, and there's also what we call the birthing team. Whoever that is for you, if that's your OB or your midwife with your husband and your
partner,
or if you have, like in my case, my nieces were there, so even my son was there, so they're part of the birthing team. How important is it that you guard the people who are gonna be with you during your time of birth?
Because everybody carries energy, right?
There.
Everybody, every person carries energy. So that's why they say sometimes an extra set of eyes in the room can prolong your labor by 10 minutes. So you need to be very particular about who you want to be present at your birth. Well, first of all, you start with the quite an intimate set of people, which is husband, wife,
partner,
the mother. and her partner, whether it's a male partner or it's a female partner, maybe from the, you know, from the relatives, right?
Right.
And then the medical care provider.
Right.
If it's a hospital setting, then it's obviously a doctor. And if it's a
lying in or home,
it's a trained, licensed midwife. Right. They are the ones who watch. Yeah, they are your safety net.
Right.
Right, in case any kind of medical attention is needed. Right. Preferably, yeah, the doula. Like to have exactly to watch that to take that whole burden of, you know, thinking what to do.
Here's a personal story.
Yeah.
When we were giving birth to the second child,
Manu,
it was already taking so long, and she says she talks to my midwife Eileen. You guys convene and then you talk about let's make her rest. Let's leave her alone.
Right.
And then I remember you specifically asking me, who do you want to be left in the room?
Right. Yeah.
You sleep first, you take a rest. Who do you want to be left with you in the room? And I said, only Joseph. And then she sent everybody out.
Yes. And sometimes the role of a doula, I feel, also is like to champion or to advocate for
advocate,
the mom. Because you're so
tired.
You're just thinking about wanting the baby
kind of scenario,
out.
Right? Yeah.
The doula does that the other things that you're supposed to do but can't because you're focused on one particular thing, which is to give birth.
Simply by knowing what can be helpful in the mother in this situation.
Right.
And, you know, even these kind of scenarios, what you just described from your birth, of like staying with just your husband to rest, they're also possible in the hospital.
Yes,
it's
exactly.
Like it's not from the realm of impossible.
Right,
exactly.
Right.
You know, you can request to rest. And on my record, we had births where it was only, well, obviously, the birthing couple, the doula, and the doctor present in the birthing suite. Like the entire pediatric team, like everybody else, were just waiting outside because mother was most comfortable with just a very
small,
intimate group of people.
I think mine was sort of like that.
Sort of. Yeah.
Like we just had like probably one nurse and then just the OB.
Yeah.
So if you really want an advocate, for me personally, that is my, I don't think I can give birth without a doula.
Yeah. Now that you've experienced it. Because your first one, you didn't have a doula.
Because I mean, I do understand some have financial constraints. They will think that I already have a midwife. Why will I need another extra pair of hands, pair of eyes? But, and I said this also earlier, that sometimes a team is better than just one set of eyes.
Yeah.
Because then even your midwife can talk to somebody and say, what do you think? Because and like what she said, it's not purely physiological. There's also like, is this woman still able to?
Right,
is she psychologically still okay?
Yeah.
Spiritually, emotionally?
Yeah.
I think it's important also that if you're considering your financial budget, you also really sit down and all these people who you plan to be with in as part of your birth team. Kasi it will also, like for me, when I consulted with Irina, when she gave me her rate, so of course, this is an additional expense on top of what I have to pay in the hospital, right? But then I was thinking, if I pay her, my chances of getting an anesthesiologist would be lower.
Right,
So that's how I actually,
Hey, can I just say that also? That having a doula increases your chances for, it doesn't guarantee.
Intervention-free birth.
The intervention-free birth.
So that's what you're looking for.
Because, again, it has a lot to do with management.
Yeah.
Pain or even pepto management.
Yes. Right.
So yeah, so with Irina, that's true. That's exactly what I was thinking. I was comparing, I was like, I'd pay the same thing to an anesthesiologist. I'd pay her this, but my chances of having intervention free would be higher with her, or at least it would be, you know, it would take longer before I take in all the
meds.
That's
so true.
Kasi nga, like, I knew she could do the massage if I'm feeling the pain and stuff. And so that's how I thought about it from a financial point of view.
Okay, so now let's move on to the part of spinning babies. In a nutshell, what is spinning babies?
So we are not going to be spinning babies, okay? We are not going to be spinning babies.
Not washing machine.
Basically, it's a set of practice, practice exercise and routines developed by a midwife, Gail Talley, from in the United States. The interventions that are actually made that, the physiological
right.
positioning.
Right.
Basically helping a mother to release certain soft tissues in the body, muscles and ligaments that can be, you know, somewhere tense, somewhere okay. spasm, to optimize the baby's position.
Right.
To get the baby in the most optimal positioning for exit. Like
exactly.
in terms of, we obviously we want to have a baby head down, right?
Mm-hmm. Yes, for cephalic
for a vagina, in a cephalic position. But a lot of varieties of the cephalic position. So it can baby can be head down with the back towards the front, or baby head down with the
right.
back towards the back, mm-hmm. or towards one side or the other side. And all of these positions make a
matter,
big difference.
Yeah.
Yes.
In terms of how baby descends, whether baby's head is nicely tucked in and straight, or it's somehow tilted.
That's true.
And the presenting part is somewhere here. So with practicing spinning babies, we minimize the chances of the baby's being presented in a less than optimal position.
Yeah.
So that's
yeah.
exactly a lifesaver yeah. for me and mine.
Yeah.
We usually think of the uterus uh-huh. and the cervix.
Right.
But we don't think about
what's beyond the uterus.
Yes. And all yeah. of you were saying soft tissues. The only time that I really understood that all of these play a part
a role,
in my
yeah.
birth. Even the coccyx,
yeah, yeah,
the tailbone,
mm-hmm.
it plays, all of them play a part in your
mm-hmm.
birth,
mm-hmm.
but all you're taught, or at least you're familiar mm-hmm. with, is
right.
the uterus
and
the cervix. You're not thinking of all the other parts of you that have to move and make way for the baby.
Yeah, because I mean, imagine it is a baby coming out, so
from
that small spot,
yeah. So right now we're gonna get up.
Right.
And we're
yeah.
gonna exercise.
Let's do that.
So if you are pregnant, you might wanna try exercising
okay.
with us. Okay?
Okay.
Alright.
Oh, remember, ladies, what you did in your preparation for your birth.
Okay.
Right? Why won't we climb
okay.
up on the couch?
I can do this,
right?
Yeah.
Okay, so what we are doing is called forward leaning inversion. Imagine we have our wonderful round.
Yes.
Family.
I don't have to imagine. It's here.
This position, we're gonna go down to the floor on our elbows. We are not gonna put the head on the floor. We're gonna keep the head up, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so what it does, it releases the ligaments that attach the uterus to
mm-hmm.
our sacrum. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
We do it every day for only 30 seconds. The 30 seconds every day investment in a baby position properly.
Mm-hmm.
But if you're having heartburn or high blood pressure or too much water in the tummy, so those are the things when you probably don't have to do it.
Okay.
Right?
Okay.
Or at risk of a stroke.
Cannot do it.
But
yeah,
yeah, like what we're talking about, healthy pregnancies.
Of course.
Yes.
Healthy mothers, right?
All
right. So yeah, so we're optimizing baby's positioning. So we go down on the elbows.
Okay.
Okay, the head is hanging, we don't put it on the floor, and stay for 3 breaths. Okay, I'm done with my 3 breaths.
Okay. Oh my gosh, when I was doing this and
yeah.
I was giving birth,
okay.
3 breaths felt like
no,
an eternity.
Darling, that was 3 contractions.
I am sorry, yeah, you're right, 3 contractions.
Yeah. Okay. No, we also use this position
in labor.
Labor.
Yeah.
If we feel
if that, yeah.
something is not happening completely right.
Okay.
Like if the baby is having harder time to descend,
mm-hmm.
or if there is a bit of leap of cervix. So that this is a
right.
position
which
that
is mine.
Can
like
that,
what
that was
to
your
me?
Case, yeah,
yeah.
That is a position that can release that and can free the way for the baby to actually descend.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah.
For like back pains and
yeah, you, those things that you probably get when you're pregnant, you
right.
also help them with those, right? Your clients, like what exercises they can take.
Back pains, yeah, it's mostly really we can practice some rebosa because that
I had a
rebosa
today.
Right?
I remember that.
Because that takes a lot of tension from the
back.
From the back.
Ayan, so there.
Potato.
Yeah. It's your third trimester. So this is to help you with your back pain.
Yeah. Okay. So and then the partner will be behind the mother and just sift like
oh, yeah.
from side to side, and usually it's very relieving.
I remember that. Yes. Yeah,
put the tension in the lower back. Oh my gosh. Area. Yeah. Remember that?
Yes, I super remember. Yeah. I would even do it with Philip.
We also did it with the during the birth itself, right?
Yeah.
So we can start doing this during pregnancy, every day or every other day for about 3 minutes, 5 minutes. So it's a nice bonding activity.
Yeah.
Right. And during the birth itself, we can also help the mother to progress in the labor and also to rest in between. All right?
Okay. All right. Thank yep. you.
All right.
So guys, there you go. You know already what a doula is all about and how important it is to have the perfect birthing team at the time of your baby's birth. So thank you, Irina.
Thank you.
Any last encouragement for all the expecting women who are probably watching this video right now?
Please own your birth.
Aww. Wow, that's so beautiful. Yeah. We're gonna talk more about that. And you actually, if you wanna attend her classes, she talks about that. Please do follow her so you get updated with her classes.
Yeah, you learn more.
Thank you so much, Irina.
Thank you.
Thanks for watching. Bye.
Bye.